So it is a lovely afternoon, happy Friday para todo mundo. Eu vou conversar agora com a Lilian Fleury, ela dá aula na Universidade de Queensland, entre outras coisas também de cultura latino-americana, e ela foi convidada para dar uma palestra a respeito de Community Language Schools. So, Dr. Fleury is with us now over the phone from
What that
Brisbane,
meant was that they were.
and we're going to talk to her about this conference that happens tomorrow in Brisbane about community language schools. Oi, Lilian, tudo bom?
Oi, tudo jóia?
Tudo
Muito bem,
legal.
Alex.
Grato aí pela disponibilidade de conversar com a gente ao vivo. Sei que não é fácil, mas é por uma boa causa.
Obrigada a você por chamar.
No worries. So listen, so tomorrow there's this big conference in Brisbane. So it's the National Community Language Schools Conference, and you are a director of a community language school in the region. You also teach at Queensland University, Latin American cultures, among other things. Can you tell me why this conference is important and what are the community language schools for people who do not know?
So community language schools, they are important to maintain the heritage language of community groups, immigrant groups. Here in Australia. And one initiative of the community is to build a community language school, which are schools, voluntary non-profit schools organized by non-English speaking groups, so usually parents, to teach their children in language and cultures of this group, no? So their languages are held outside normal school hours after 4 p.m. or on weekends, usually Saturdays, so they are also called Saturday schools. And yeah, that's what a community language school
is.
And this,
yeah, go on.
Now this this conference is it's very important to train or to talk more about how to manage these schools, and it's addressed for parents, teachers, and directors of community language schools.
Very good. And why do you think it's important that we have community language schools? Because not so long ago, people would say that in order to assimilate, migrants should only speak English and that's it, because it is the national language. So how do you respond to that?
Well, we have, we live now in a globalized world. So being bilingual is something that we all pursue, I think. I always thought, like, to raise my kids bilingual, just for the fact that it's so hard to acquire a language after you're grown up. And when you keep the language and you teach your child simultaneously two languages, they can easily become fully bilingual adults. So this is the importance. The problem is the language they speak here, like I speak Portuguese to my kids. So this is called the heritage language. And the dominant language here is English. And it's very easily, they easily lose this language when they start school. And here is when the community language school starts. They give these children the environment to keep up speaking this language with other kids, which is very important. It's very important for their identity as, you know, people from other culture, and definitely to keep them proficient with this heritage, the family language, as they become more detached, let's say, from the family when they grow up. They tend to start, like, losing this language. And also 6 hours of class in normal schools, regular school, make them lose it. So community language schools is one initiative to keep up with the language, to keep up with this bilingualism. But other initiatives from the community is also very important. So that's one of the importance I would highlight.
Beautiful. And I understand that you were talking about specifically in tomorrow's conference about challenges people might face when they put this initiative together, because a lot of people, obviously, they do on goodwill. It's the best for the kids. They want the kids to grow up with this identity, with the, you know, this cultural identity, so they can relate with their relatives in their parents' country, have more opportunities. Knowing more languages is good for the brain. It's it should be common sense, but obviously something that we have to talk more and more and more and more. But it's not only goodwill. So people, when they actually put stuff together and start the community language school, they face challenges. And I think you are specifically talking about the challenges tomorrow, aren't you? The whole idea is come up with solutions.
Yeah, I came up, at the beginning, I start with this naive idea of I'll make a community language score. I'll just make a group of kids at my kids' age, you know, to keep up speaking with the language. But then you face lots of challenges throughout the way that might demotivate you to continue. It's very, very common. So what I'm talking tomorrow, it's about this. I'll bring to the participants I'll present or explain some of these challenges that we normally face. And then we will discuss ways of addressing these challenges. And one of these challenges, they vary, like, for example, getting program foundings or finding meeting spaces or deal with the diversity of the students' language skills and background, or students' recruitment and retention, teacher recruitment and training, teaching material. All these things are very hard to solution or to address if you're doing this work by yourself. So I think having this opportunity to talk to other people who are facing different challenges as well, or addressing in a different way the same challenges, is the opportunity that I'm trying to bring to this workshop.
Beautiful. And, thank you so much. Yeah, I think it's a great idea. So you also can build a network of people that are going through the same thing, and they can all help each other as well. All right. So that's Lilian Fleury. She's a teacher in the Queensland University. She will be talking tomorrow at the National Community Language Schools Conference that happens at the 15 Chester Road, Annerley in Queensland. And I suppose that's Brisbane, from 9:30 to 4 p.m. Okay, so thank you so much. Good luck. And if anybody wants to talk to Lilian, you can reach her through her email, littlebrazil.brisbane@gmail.com, littlebrazil.brisbane@gmail.com. And she also runs a language school called Raízes Brasileiras, and you can also find them on the internet. It's Brazilian Roots translated, raízesbrasileiras.org. I'll put that on our Facebook page pretty soon. Brazil Central Radio on Facebook. You'll have all the info there if you want to reach Lilian. Thank you so much for your time today, Lilian.
Thank you, Alex. See you later.
Okay, see you later. Muito bem, essa foi a Lilian falando aí a respeito da importância das escolas, né, para ensinar as crianças brasileiras nascidas aqui e até outras crianças de outros lugares a aprender o português. E amanhã, especificamente nessa conferência em Brisbane, vão falar dos desafios. Just to remind you guys that here in the Shire we have schools, Brazilian Portuguese lessons every Wednesday on Brunswick Public School, at the Brunswick Public School. So if you also want to know more about that, and we also have Australian kids there. They're not Brazilian related by blood, but by love for the culture. Get in touch with us on our Facebook page, Brazil Central Radio on Facebook, and I can tell you a little bit more about that.